Good morning, students. In a last lesson, we took information about the wind and its type. Today, we are going to start a very interesting lesson of geography. That is lesson number 6, natural reasons. How many natural reasons are there? Which type of animals and the trees are there? Which type of houses they build? How the people live in that area? Their information we are going to learn in this lesson. Okay, the first one. See this picture carefully. What you seen in this picture? Correct. We see the different type of houses. Some are made from the wood, some are made from the ice, some are made from the cement. As well as the size and the structure of houses are different. Why it's occur? Why people build the different types of houses? Anyone can guess? See in this figure, you are able to see the different types of the clothes. Yes? Different people uses the different type of clothes. Here also people use the different types of clothes. Some uses the warm clothes, some uses the light clothes. Why people use the different types of clothes? See this figure carefully. Every one of you want to eat this food? Yes, certainly you want to eat this food. Here also the variety of food we are able to see. Some food items made from the rice, some made from the wheat, some are made from the maize, means the from different grains we made these different items. In a North India, people eat wheat more, and in a South India, people eat more rice. Why it? Why the people use like this grain in a different area? Anyone can guess? Okay. Now see this picture. Different types of animal we found in this picture. Some live in desert, some found in forest, some found in river, or some are found in a different areas. Are you able to see a polar bear near about your home? Certainly answer is no. Why we are not able to see the polar bears in our area? Anyone can say the answer of this? Okay, many questions are there in your mind. People use different type of houses, people use different type of clothes, people use to eat the different types of food items, different animals we are able to see in a different climate. All these things or the answers of all these questions are there in a one. That is, due to the natural reasons, life of the people and the animals mostly depend upon these things. Okay, whatever the natural sources available in that region, they use that natural resources and they made their life easier. They are different in landforms, climate, soil. Due to this, we are able to see the variety of houses, clothing, food, animals, trees, etc. Living style of a human is depend upon the natural reasons. For example, in a forest or in an equatorial region, people made the houses from wood, whereas in a heavy rainfall areas, they made the slope on their roof, means their housing pattern changes with the natural reasons. Okay, whatever the natural areas are there, due to this their housing pattern change. In a desert, they use the less clothes, but in a polar region, they use the warm clothes in an equatorial region. High trees are there, but in a polar region, small bushes, and in a desert, the cactus are there. Means regarding to the temperature, regarding to the climate, there things change. The area which produces more rice, people in that area eat rice more. Work or the occupation also changes with the natural reasons. In the forest, people hunt or collect the resin or honey, medicinal things. When the people living in a city, they engage in a different occupations. Means we can say that the housing pattern, clothing, vegetations, animals, food pattern, occupation of the people, all these things depend upon a natural regions. Due to the difference in a temperature, rotation of a earth, shape of a earth, there are six main types of a natural regions are there. We are going to learn these six different natural regions in this lesson. Okay. Now learn the first one. Tundra region. Tundra region is located between 65 to the 90 degree parallel. Tundra region spread in Greenland, North Canada, North Europe and North Asia. The climate of this region is very cold. In a summer, temperature of a tundra region is 10 degree Celsius. But in a winter, it is minus 20 to minus 30 degree Celsius. Average rainfall in the tundra region is 25 to the 300 millimeter. Okay, see the area covered by the tundra region shown you in a blue color. Now, we found a short-lived vegetations in this region because 6 months less sunlight is there. So, the short grass, flowers, leaves we found in a tundra region. See in this picture how the small grasses are there, bushes are there. The next one is there. Main animals in tundra regions are reindeer, polar bear, fox, etc. We find animals with the soft and the thick fur in this region. You are able to see the different animals which we found in a tundra region in this picture. See this picture carefully. Okay. The population of this region is very less. Eskimo type of people live in this region. They make the houses from ice. That houses are called as igloo. The hunting and the fishing is main occupation of these people. See in this picture the Eskimo type of people shown to you. Less population is there due to the cold in this area. Okay, understood the tundra region? Okay, come on the next one. The next is taiga region. See in this map, the taiga region shown you in a green color. Okay, taiga region is located between 55 to 65 degree north parallel. Means from the Alaska to the Atlantic coast. See in this figure, this is a part of Eurasia. You are able to see in a green color. Climate of this region is also cold. In summer, temperature of this region is 15 degree to 20 degree Celsius. In a winter, temperature go below 0 degree Celsius. Average 300 to the 500 millimeter rainfall is there. In summer, rainfall is there and in winter, snowfall is there. Okay. Now see which type of trees are there in this area. Coniferous forest found in this region. Yes. Leaves of a trees are narrow and pointed towards the ground. You are able to see here how the trees are there. बिकॉज इफ स्नोफॉल इज देयर इजिली इट कैन कम ऑन द ग्राउंड दैट्स वाई द पॉइंटेड ट्रीज आर देयर इन दिस रीजन. ओके द वुड इज हाई एंड सॉफ्ट इट इज द लाइट एंड द सॉफ्ट वुड वी आर एबल टू गेट फ्रॉम दिस ट्रीज. वी फाउंड ट्रीज लाइक स्पर स्प्रूस पाइन इन दिस रीजन. The names of trees are very important. The question will be asked on this. Which type of food we are able to find in a taiga region? Then you have to write the names of these trees. Which trees we are able to find? Spur, spruce, pine, etc. Okay. Now see the animals. Animals have soft and the thick fur in this region. We found animals like bear, silver fox, ermine, elk in this region. Okay, some photos are given to you of different animals in this region. Are you able to see this? Okay. Now see, the population of this area or region is very less due to the cold. Main occupation of people is hunting. People hunt the animals. And whatever the people living in this area, in that some are engaged into the agriculture, means some people do the agriculture. Okay, got it? Okay, now we will turn to the next one, grassland. It is of the steppes and the prairie type of grassland. There are two types of grasslands. First we will learn here steppes and the prairie type of grassland. This grassland shown to you in a dark green color. You are able to see in this map. This region is located between 30 degree to 55 degree north and south parallel. This region spread across Eurasia, South Africa, North America and the Australia. In a summer, temperature is about 27 degree Celsius. In a winter, temperature decreases up to the 0 degree Celsius. Average 400 to the 600 millimeter rainfall is there. We experiences most of the rainfall in a summer. When the rainfall is there in a grasslands? In a summer, most of the rainfall is there in a grasslands. Okay? Are you able to see this one? Where it is located, how the extents are there. Extents are very important of every type of natural regions, because for one mark they will ask to you one question. Write the extent of taiga region, write the extent of the grassland, means you have to know in which parallels they situated. Okay. On a large scale, we found grass in this area. Due to the extreme cold, grass died in a winter. Elder and the poplar trees are found in this region. Now see, variety of animals are found in this region. For example, deer, dog, donkey, horse, tiger, rabbit, many animals we are able to find in this area. See this figure carefully. Different animals in a grassland and their names are given to you. Read it carefully and see the pictures. Okay. All these animals are found in this region. Whatever shown you in this picture. Okay. Now how the human settlements are there? Earlier people had a nomadic age. Or Adivasi people live in this area. Yes, the rearing of animals is a main occupation of these people. People live in a tent, called it yurt. Okay, people live in a small tent and that tent is called as yurt. Some people engage in agriculture and they grow the wheat. Which type of grain they produce? They produce the wheat. Understood this? Okay. Now द नेक्स्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट रीजन और द एरिया नेचुरल रीजन वॉट इट इज हॉट डेजर्ट. एवरी वन ऑफ यू फैमिलियर विद द डेजर्ट. यू सीन इन ए मूवीज, यू सीन द फोटोज ऑफ द डेजर्ट. नाउ वी विल टेक सम इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द डेजर्ट्स इन ए वर्ल्ड. Here the deserts are shown you in a yellow color. You are able to see. The hot desert region is located between 20 degree to 30 degree parallel in a both hemisphere. Names of the some famous deserts are Sahara in North America, Colorado in a North America, Atacama in a South America, Kalahari in a South Africa, and Sahara in Asia. The names are very important. Which are they? Sahara, Colorado, Atacama, Kalahari and the Sahara. Okay. Temperature is very high at a day and at night very cold is there. In summer, average 30 degree to 45 degree temperature is there. In a winter, 20 degree to 25 degree temperature is there. The tremendous heat and the very less rainfall are found in this region. Now, which type of trees? Mostly you know how the cactus found in this region. Now, due to the less rainfall, the less vegetation are found in this area. Thorny bushes with the hard leaves are found in this area. Leaves are narrow and oily. See here, some examples are shown to you. Cactus, palm trees, we are able to see in a desert. Okay. Which type of animals are there? Camels survive without water for a many days. Many times question will be asked to you for true and false for on the basis of this. Camel live without water for a whole life. It is a wrong. Okay, it is a false statement. Camel survive without water for some days or many days. He drink water and for next some days, 10 days, 15 days, he will survive without water. Okay. So, we found more camels in this region. Camels are called sheep of the desert. Less number of animals are found in this region. In that one, snakes, rats, lizards, scorpions, like this able, we are able to find in a desert. Now, which type of people live in that area? We found Bushman people in a Kalahari desert. Where we find? We find Bushman people in a Kalahari desert. Most of people fulfill their needs through the animals. Agriculture is found in a river valleys. Means whatever some rivers are there in the desert, in near about that rivers, we are able to find in a less amount agriculture. But mostly people engage into the depend upon the animals for their daily life. Okay. Now the next important region, that is the grassland of Sudan type. First we learn the grassland. Now it is the second type of grassland. It is of Sudan type. See in this one. In a dark black color, the Sudan type of grassland shown to you. Okay. The Sudan type of grasslands are located between 5 degree to 20 degree parallels in a both hemisphere. Some names of the grasslands are savanna in Africa, compass in South America. Okay, names are very important. Savanna and the compass are the two names of Sudan types of the grassland. Underline these lines into the textbook. Okay, in summer, average temperature is near about 35 degrees Celsius and around 250 to the 1000 millimeter rainfall is there. Okay. See in this map the Sudan type of grassland shown to you. Okay. Hot and humid and the warm and dry winters are there in this region. tall and the thick grass is found. This grass is known as the elephant grass, and we are able to see some trees in this area. For example, acacia, sisal, pineapple, etc. Okay. Large number of herbivorous animals are found in this area. For example, zebra, hyena, horses, elephants, kangaroos, buffalo, ox, tiger, etc. We are found in this area. Okay. Many tribes communities live in this region. For example, Zulu, Hausa, Maasai. Yes, which type of which animals or the which communities, tribe communities live in this region? The names of these communities are Zulu, Hausa and Maasai. They are mainly engaged in hunting and the rearing the animals. They live in a simple houses. They made short height houses are called as dome. See in this one, near about 5 feet houses are there. Easily we can enter in that one, but height is very small. These houses are known as the dome. Okay. Now, the next and the last important region is the equatorial region. The equatorial region shown to you in this map with the yellow color. Equatorial region situated near about equator. That's why it is known as equatorial region. Equatorial region is located between 5 degree north to the 5 degree south parallel. This region mainly spread through Malaysia, Indonesia, Singapore, Guyana and the Amazon basin. In a summer, temperature is around 30 degree Celsius. Average 2500 to the 3000 millimeter rainfall is there. Hot and humid climate leads many diseases in this region. Okay, more rainfall as well as more heat we are able to experience in this equatorial region. See here, dense and the evergreen forest are found in this area. The variety of trees and the bushes are found on a large scale. Trees are tall and wood is hard. For example, rosewood, ebony, greenheart, mahogany, etc. We are able to see the different types of the trees in a equatorial region. Many times you see the movies in that one, dense forest we are able to see. All these dense forests situated in a equatorial region. Okay. See the different types of animal live in this region. Crocodiles, anacondas, we are able to find in a marshy lands. Due to the heavy rainfall here, many marshy lands are there, and in that area crocodiles, anacondas we are able to find. The animals like gorilla, chimpanzee live on the trees, and many poisonous insects are found in this area. Okay. Now, the human settlements. Human settlement is very less in this region. Population is mostly tribe. Who are living in this region? Mostly the tribe people, who are the Adivasi people, they live in the equatorial region. Human life is depend upon the nature. People collect resin, wood, honey, as well as medicinal things from the forest. The tribes, which type of the tribe people, what are their names? The Pygmies, Boro live in this forest in equatorial region. Okay. Pygmies from Africa and the Boro from Indians, which live in that equatorial region. Understood this? The remaining part we will learn in a next period. Thank you.